Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here from RoboDK. Welcome to the second video on our SolidWorks plugin. To follow up with what we saw in the first tutorial, we will reuse the example with a table and two angle irons to show you how you can use RoboDK's feature to improve your welding paths. Before going further, I highly recommend you to take a look at the first video. It shows you how to import parts, curves, and points from SolidWorks using our plugin. Okay, let's get to work. In the first video, I showed you how to import from SolidWorks the part and the welding paths. Let's do that again real quick. Let's go on the RoboDK tab, click Auto Setup, select the welding paths, and don't forget the faces, they help orient the robot tool. Okay, just like that. Okay, perfect. Back to RoboDK. We have the same result as before. In the station tree, I can click on Weld 1 Settings. That will open the Curve Follow project. I can now click Update and Simulate. The welding gun is actually following the path as it's supposed to do, but we can see that the orientation is a bit weird, and we can see that the path is far from optimal. Fixing those will be our main goals today. Let's start by fixing the path itself. In the Curve Follow project, click on Select Curve. That shows us the order in which the robot will do the paths, going from 1 to 2, then 3 to 4, then 5 to 6, followed by 7 to 8, and finally 9 to 10. The order for the welding sections makes sense. But what doesn't seem to make sense is the welding direction of some. For example, the 3 to 4 path could be the other way around. To switch it, right-click the path and select Switch Sense. You can see that the arrow of that path changed direction. We can do the same with 5 to 6 and the 7 to 8 path. Once your modifications are done, you can click Done in the left window, or you can right-click an empty space in the station and click Done. Now, if I update and simulate, I can see that the order of the paths seems to make more sense. Now, I can adjust the orientation of the tool along the path to better suits my needs. Again, in the Curve Follow project, I can click on Show Preferred Tool Path. A bunch of ghost tools will appear to show you the orientation of the tool at different steps of the program. The first tool orientation options you can try is the Path to Tool Offsets around the Z-axis. To do so, you can either manually enter a value here, or bring your mouse over it and use your scroll wheel to bring the value up and down. While I'm doing that, you can see the orientation of the ghost tools changing. In this case, this basic option doesn't seem to fix our problem. Fortunately, we have more options to work with. You can reveal them by clicking the blue plus here. All of them can be useful for your specific project. I recommend you to play with them to better understand their behaviors. But here, for the sake of not having an hour-long video, I will keep most of these options for a future tutorial. I will simply change the rod Z to its original value, so 0, and click on the plus Z button. As you can see with the ghost tools, the robot flange will always be on top of the part. Let's click update and simulate. That seems very good. As you can see, if I use the scroll bar, that orientation facilitates the cable management of the tool. It has no risk of interfering with the robot. Talking about interfering, approach and retract movements are very important to avoid collisions between the tool and the part. A curve follow project automatically creates an approach and a retract for every welding path. By default, these movements are 100 mm long and are normal to the welding path. We can modify them to be, let's say, 200 mm long and keep the orientation, just like that. As you can see, the approach and retract movement are simply twice their previous length. We could also change some movements. I'll put back the default one to 100 mm, and I'll add, let's say, a movement along Z. I'll set it to 50 millimeters. Okay, let's do the same with the retract. As you can see, now the robot retract normal to the welding pad and then straight up. That should help you avoid any collisions. Okay, that's pretty much everything for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, subscribe to our channel. I will be posting a bunch of things related to RoboDK and its new features. Leave a comment below if you think we should cover a particular topic. And don't forget to visit our forum if you have any question about RoboDK and its features. Have a good day, guys.